you were stuck in the biggest earthquake of all time, what would you do? So we're here today at Brendan Theaters watching San Andreas. Now I'm going to preface by saying that I'm not a big fan of disaster movies. And I know that Jeff likes the specific types of movies, but wasn't able to be with us today. So I'm actually going to be hosting this one. This movie, not really my thing. From the beginning to the end of the movie, the writing was really, really bad. People were saying things that make you roll your eyes. People were doing things that make you roll your eyes. Actual plot points that got revealed were really, really bad. Rolled my eyes, to be repetitive. There were a lot of moments in this movie where you're like, that is so cliche. I actually don't know anything that was done originally in this movie from other disaster movies. It is pretty predictable all the way through. Special effects are mind-blowing. Some of the things that happen in this movie special effect-wise will just blow your mind. They are at a whole new level for disaster movies, at least the ones I've seen. They don't skimp on the details. So if you look in the background or if you look past the people that you're supposed to be focusing on, there's little details in the background that you wouldn't expect that they didn't have to take time to do. The sound is amazing. Actually, the sound was so good in our theater, I think it actually blew one of the speakers. By the end of our showing, one of them was buzzing really bad. I think it might have blown it. I mean, it shook the whole theater. The cinematography is great. The actual look and feel of the movie was great. The story, some of the acting, overall, the entertainment value, really poor. I found myself putting my face in my hands multiple times in the movie, not because I was like so invested in what just happened, but I was like, that actually just happened. I don't say this much because this isn't my forte. I'm pretty sure I could have written some of those scenes better. So it is what it is. It is a disaster movie. I know our theater was packed, so I know it's a very popular genre. And from some of the clapping I was hearing in the audience at certain points in the movie, I might have been a minority opinion. We will find out when we hear what our guests have to say if my opinion was not the same as the rest. I'm going to give this movie a 4 out of 10. And the only reason I gave it a 4 out of 10 was the special effects and Alexandria Daddario. She gets at least 2 of those points for herself. So let's see what our guests have to say.
I enjoyed this movie because of the fact it was an action-packed, which I always do like the action-packed. It was one of those doomsday almost type thing, like this is going on, this could happen. But it was very much, like you said, easy. Everything was coming right at you and you knew it was coming at you. And some of the parts that were going on, it was like I was sitting there going, oh no, don't do that, oh, there it happened. And to me, you know, that was just, it took out all the fun. It took out all the suspense that I always look for in a movie in the first place. You know, I liked the special effects and all that. I liked what they did with it to try to make it look realistic, but everything else about it, I didn't enjoy it. I mean, I sat there probably doing this most of the time, probably looking stupid around everybody, but I just...
I saw it, he did.
Yeah, I couldn't stand it. Sometimes I felt like I needed to cover my eyes. That was that bad. I'm gonna give this movie a 5 because I did love those special effects. I did love how they made it look so real, like to the point where I'm thinking this could be, you know, my backyard very soon.
It was better than 2012, I'll give it that. The plot was cliche, which was expected, but the acting was better. Dialogue, not that much better. Whatever. But I'm willing to forgive the cliches for the awesome disaster action, the visual effects, a lot of long single shots where the camera doesn't cut away to another shot during the earthquake sequences. I was really impressed by that. There was hardly ever a time when I was like, that looked kind of fake. There was one shot where a building was collapsing and the dust was coming at the camera. I thought that looked a little fake, but everything else just looked so photorealistic. It wouldn't surprise me if this got an Oscar nomination, not just for best visual effects, but for sound editing and sound mixing. The theater shook like crazy, blowing out speakers. So if anything, it was almost too good to get nominated. But those are the 3 nominations I would expect for this movie to get, at least in those categories. It certainly won't get Best Picture or anything like that, obviously. The best earthquake film since the movie Earthquake by Charlton, was starring Charlton Heston back in 1970, or 71, I think it was 1970. But the best disaster movie for me since Dante's Peak, and before that, Twister. So we've got Twister with tornadoes, Dante's Peak with volcanoes, and now San Andreas with earthquakes. Finally a good earthquake movie since Earthquake 1970, of course. I'm gonna give this a 8 out of 10. Because even though all the cliches you point out, all the bad stuff, I like the movie for its disaster epicness and action. That I enjoy, since I'm a visual effects artist myself, I enjoy watching that stuff. And the music is also worth a note to this. I might get the soundtrack. So, 8 out of 10.
So my question for you is, what's your favorite disaster movie? So head down to the comments, leave us a comment letting us know your favorite disaster movie, and if you saw this movie, let us know what you thought. Did you agree with me? Did you disagree with me? What about our guests? Did you agree with our guests or disagree with our guests? I'd love to hear it. So personally, my favorite disaster movie is Twister. A little old school, I really enjoyed that movie. It had a good story, the cliches hadn't been done yet, so they were new. And the acting was good enough where it kept the story going where you cared about the characters. And I think that's all you can really ask from a disaster movie. Plus, the special effects at the time were amazing. Obviously a little dated now, but pretty amazing at the time. Don't forget to like, favorite, subscribe, like us on Facebook, and toss a comment down below. Every little bit helps, and we sure love hearing from you. And as always, we're letting you know before you go, the Brennan Theaters.